be with you.
And with your
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed him his hands and feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Do you have anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are the witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Most Reverend Father, on behalf of the catechists and the entire community of St. Charles Borromeo, it is my honor to present to you our candidates for the Sacrament of Confirmation. Through catechesis, prayer, and the support of their family and church, they have persevered and are now ready to be strengthened by the power of the Holy Spirit in the Sacrament of Confirmation. Each one of them is accompanied by a sponsor, and it is my privilege to present them to you at this time. I now ask our candidates for the Sacrament of Confirmation to please stand. Your Excellency, trusting in God's mercy and love, we humbly request you to administer the Sacrament of Confirmation to these 19 brothers and sisters.
Every time Jesus appeared to the apostles after he rose from the dead, do you know what the first words were out of his mouth? "Peace be with you." Say, "Peace be with you." That's why when a bishop says Mass anywhere, anytime, any season of the year, Lent, Easter, instead of saying, "The Lord be with you," a bishop is supposed to say, as I did, "Peace be with you." The bishop's presence is supposed to bring peace to the community, which it usually does to everyone in the congregation except the pastor. Just teasing, Father. Okay. Yeah. I could tell you stories. Your saint over here, St. Charles Borromeo, here he is. He was a reforming bishop in Milan right after the Council of Trent, and the priests in Milan wanted nothing to do with reform. They were stealing money from the collection. They had girlfriends and even wives and children on the side. And he held a meeting of the priests, and he said, "From now on, as long as I'm bishop, there's to be no stealing from the collection, and you're to put away your girlfriends and your wives, and you're to live only for the service of God and his people." And as he turned to leave the room and go out the door, a dagger went right into the door from one of the priests. Thank you very much. tried to kill him. But that's not the case today. Thank you. No, it's no, I want to say something about peace, especially to you young people being confirmed. It's easy to say, peace be with you. Don't we do it at Mass? You know, we turn around and say, give the sign of peace, the kiss of peace, handshake of peace. But peace comes from living our life and understanding our life with spiritual eyesight. There's two ways to look at your life, through the eyes of the world or through the eyes of faith. Let me tell you what I mean by that. One of my friends, and I went to visit him, I said, how are things going in your family? Oh, terrible. Terrible, my daughter. She's in high school. She's in a terrible mood. I said, well, what happened? She ran for cheerleader at her high school, and she didn't get elected. And it was like her life was over. You know, she was very upset. She was moody. I'm not popular. And that could be if you try out for the basketball team and you get cut. I remember I was coach in high school of a water polo team. And way more boys tried out for the team than you could accept. And it's not fair to have a team of 40 when only, you know, six play at a time. So on the day after the tryouts, I had to put up the team list. I'll never forget in the schoolyard, I was walking, you know, the list was up for a while. One of the boys who didn't make the team ran over to me and he said, Mr. Barber, did you forget to put my name on the list? My heart went out to him. You know, he was crushed. But see, we normally look at our life through the eyes of the world. And so our happiness or our sadness goes up or down depending on what the world thinks of us or even false hopes and goals that we make for ourselves. And you can protect yourself from that if you look at your life through the eyes of faith. I'll give another example. One of my high school students, he was a senior, he asked me to write an especially strong letter of recommendation for him because he wanted to go to Stanford University. And of course, he applied to like 10 colleges. He got accepted to 9. And the one he didn't make it into was Stanford. And it, you know, it was Cal, it was all nice, worthy universities that anyone else would be very happy to be accepted to. No, he had said to himself, I won't be happy unless I get into Stanford. Well, that's a very narrow way of looking at things. And he asked me after he got his letter of rejection, would I write another letter of recommendation? So I did for him. And then I didn't see him for like 10 years until we had a 10-year reunion. And I said, well, oh, I remember the last time I saw you, you were so upset. What happened, like, to your life? You know, it's been 10 years. He goes, oh, no, it was just the right thing that I went to Cal instead of Stanford, because not only did I get my degree, but I met my future wife there. So you see, if you have the eyes of faith, you will know then that God and the Holy Spirit and divine providence will be guiding you in your life with ways that are unknown to you that you can't see. And you have to trust that God knows more than you do. He knows more than I do. Now, in the past 2 weeks, I don't know if any of you golf. I'm sure out here in Livermore there's nice golf courses, and it must be, I mean, even though it's a little dry right now. But if you follow golf, something just wonderful happened in the golf world on TV, the Masters tournament out of Georgia. One of the youngest people ever in the history of that golf tournament won. His 21-year-old young man, I almost said kid, excuse me, you know, when I'm old. 21-year-old kid won the Masters. He beat out Tiger Woods, beat out all the famous pro golfers to win that tournament. And the prize is you get a special green jacket. And they showed this young fellow, his name is Jordan Spieth, winning and giving his speech. And all the reporters were there like, how could so young a person win this famous golf tournament? And he said, when he got his green jacket, he said, it's the happiest day of my life, but I dedicate it to my sister. She's 11, and she has autism. It's a neurological disorder, okay? And he says, my sister is my biggest fan, and she adores me. You know how young sisters looked up to him. And he said, she's the most precious member of our family, and she has this autism. And they showed the little girl on the TV. And as Jordan was playing every, you know, hole, and he'd hit the ball into the hole, his sister would say, did you win? Did you win? And then he'd say, no, I got another one to go, another one to go, until the finals, and he won. And the sister was jumping up and down for joy. Now, in the eyes of the world, Jordan Spieth is a huge success. Wow, 21, you've already achieved a goal that many golfers work for decades to achieve. But maybe that was not the reason God gave him the natural talent to be a golfer. Mm-mm. Maybe it was because he would now have a world stage to draw attention to the value of people who are born with disabilities, to send a message out there that people with disabilities are a source of love in a family. That maybe people or mothers that discover they have a baby in their womb that has a disability or will allow their child to be born to be loved and to bring love to a family. Maybe through the eyes of faith, that's why Jordan Spieth is a success. Jordan Spieth, 8 years, St. Monica's Catholic Grammar School, 4 years, Jesuit High School in Dallas, Texas. Baptism, First Communion, First Confession, Confirmation. So the gifts given you today in your confirmation, the 7 gifts of the Holy Spirit, a share in Christ's own divinity, given to you not just to make you richer, smarter, more successful in life. They're gifts given to you for the benefit of someone else. And if you look at your life through the eyes of faith, you will find, in the end, everything will be all right. Everything will be all right. You would never have to worry. You may want to get elected to this. You may want to get promoted to that. You may want to win this prize. You may want to be on this team. You may want to go to that school. You may want to go to that. Even if you don't get what you want, you say, Lord, put me where I'm meant to be. And he will. And then you will have peace. So when you come to Mass, you hear the readings, you receive communion, and you hear peace be with you, you'll know what it means. And everything will go right in your life from this day forward. God bless you guys. Will those who are going to receive confirmation please stand? My dear candidates, before you receive the Holy Spirit, I ask you to renew the profession of faith you made in baptism, or your parents and godparents made in union with the whole church. And so I ask you, do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who came upon the apostles at Pentecost and today is given to you sacramentally in confirmation?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. My dear friends,
In baptism, God our Father gave the new birth of eternal life to his chosen sons and daughters. Let us pray to our Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit to strengthen his sons and daughters with his gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Bishop, may I present Veronica Sarah.
Veronica Sarah, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bishop, I present to you Cecilia.
Okay. Catherine Cecilia, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Daniel Joseph, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. You know who Stanislaus Koska is? Who is he?
Spirit.
Now you have the same Holy Spirit that the apostles received at Pentecost. And if the church was just reduced to U19, you could refound the Catholic Church, given the same power that the apostles received. Let's congratulate our newly confirmed members.